Alright, on the draw here. Ooh, I will not like to mulligan this. Mystic Gate's gonna do a little bit of work. Got turn two Silver Knight again. But I think the odds that my opponent plays a turn on Mountain are substantially lower than they were before I played my last opponent. Oh, never mind. Turn on Mountain. There we go. Just play Island. Baneslayer might be a good draw too. It's unclear whether this is also an aggressive red deck, but we will find out fairly shortly. Yeah. Thought that was a little less likely. Alright, still playing Silver Knight. Because that way, next turn, I can get Blue-White off the Mystic Gate and then cast Preordain and then cast Kami of Ancient Law after I, for sure, find a land. Yeah, Silver Knight's not the worst against Blue-Red. I can crack in for a few points of damage. And my hand is, like, fairly decent. Narcolepsy. Alright, well, I've got not only Kami of Ancient Law, but Restoration Angel. That's a lot of value. Oh, yeah, let's just get blue-white here and cast Preordain. Wouldn't mind seeing a land. Absorb isn't bad, but, you know, I don't think I actually want it. I think I'm just going to keep the lands. I'm playing this, play Kami, but I'm not actually going to use Kami on the Narcolepsy here. Keeping the land on top is a little conservative, but I would like to play Baneslayer Angel, and maybe I could have kept Absorb under the land. Yeah, that might have actually been better. I figured I have a lot of stuff to do, so I didn't really want it, but I actually think, given my hand, it's going to be pretty decent, especially if I keep up Restoration Angel as well, so... Alright, yeah, would not have minded keeping the Absorb around. Alright, what's happening here? A Fireball of some kind? Explosives for two. Alright, well, there goes all of the things, including my sweet Restoration Angel play, unfortunately. Well, let's not play that and attack with Conviction Law. Unfortunately, Restoration Angel does not do much against Engineered Explosives, so I'm just going to play that, untap, and pass. I figure, well, I thought things were going to get exploded, but I guess not. I guess I can kind of force it at the end of turn by playing Restoration Angel, which I am going to do. And blinking Silver Knight here. Don't really want to burn Electrolyze yet. This puts 7 points of power on the board, so yeah, that makes sense. That goes away. I untap, draw. Counterspell's not actually horrible, so let's play Honor of the Pure, leaving Counterspell mana up. I don't really want to tap out for our Vesuvian Shapeshifter at this point, especially now that I've drawn Counterspell. Alright, still don't really know what's going on. It looks just like a blue-red-white control deck, which is, you know, always fairly reasonable. Probably countering this. Actually not. My opponent's already got 6 lands in play, so the 10th doesn't really matter too much. So, hopefully countering whatever my opponent plays off that Guild Lotus at some point. Alright, draw Looter Ilkor. Vendilion Click, alright. I could counter it, but I think that's not great. I think I'd rather just Electrolyze it, leaving Mystic Gate up. I assume my counterspell is going to get taken here, but that's okay. Get a little bit more value this way, I think. I can't imagine my opponent's got that many targets for Vendilion Click in that deck over there. And even if Counterspell gets taken, I still get to play a Looter this turn and smash for 4 at the Angel, which I think leaves me in an okay spot, though. I mean, this is Cube, and my opponent's about to have 9 or 10 mana up, which anything could happen. I mean, maybe this person took Guild Lotus and wheeled up people, which is insane, but could happen. I mean, there aren't that many people at the table who actually can play up people, and I actually don't think I was one of them. Alright, unsurprisingly, the counterspell went. Let's play Looter and smash with a Restoration Angel. So, yeah, I mean, I do have Sower and Shapeshifter, so I've got some amount of protection against some plays, but again, like a Wildfire here. Well, I guess actually this survives Wildfire, but whatever this is, it's probably not going to be great for me. Tamiyo, I guess I can live with. There's only 2 cards left, 1 card left. Alright, we're about to see the last card, so. Could actually be in not terrible shape. Well, I drew Sower of Temptation, which is actually the most insane counter to Glenhalandra Archmage. I'm just going to hit my opponent for one, because I would like to loot here. And because I'm not too worried about Tamiyo, I discard it's going to be a Mary or a Baneslayer. I like Frost Titan here. Actually going to discard Baneslayer, I think, because I like Shapeshifter. I still can't believe my opponent played a Glenhalandra Archmage, which, again, Sword of Temptation's always been the insanest counter to that. Rather, the most insane counter to it. So let's play Sower. taking Glenlinger Archmage and leaving Archmage up. The reason I discarded Baneslayer was, yeah. My opponent punted me, so I had to respond in kind, obviously. I figure playing multiple guys by drawing a land and playing Angel Land is better, especially with Honor of the Pure up. But, alright, so Tamiyo can draw a card, but then I get to attack for lethal, so Tamiyo probably has to lock down Angel. Glenlinger Archmage is going to stop a lot of things. I guess I have near lethal in play already, so you might as well draw cards off Tamiyo. Maybe draw something sweet. I'm not sure what qualifies as sweet, but we'll find out. Thuran Dynamo, yeah, that certainly resolves. And a card I'm going to counter unless it's an Inferno Titan. 7 mana? That's like a Wildfire. This looks like a Wildfire deck if I've ever seen one. A lot of insane cards of Wildfire. Gilded Lotus, Tamiyo, Thuran Dynamo. Even Archmage actually has got some pretty decent Wildfire synergy. Uh-oh. What is this? I don't know what it is, but it costs a lot of mana and my opponent is unsure of how to pay for it. But Garden Hellkite. Alright, this game is not yet over. I mean, it's pretty close to over, but, like, my opponent does get to kill Sower and Archmage. No, it doesn't want to kill Archmage. It gets to kill Sower and Looter and do 2 to me, I think is probably best. You get Archmage back. Still got an Angel in play. I, however, get to cast Shapeshifter, and kind of wish I had countered a Dynamo now, but I don't think that was right. I get to play Shapeshifter to counter to a Garden Hellkite if I wish. Which I think I do, because I get to play Hellkite. I can shoot down Tamiyo and the Glenlinger Archmage. Or, let's see. I'm trying to think what is the sweetest play here. Because I can attack with Angel, and it'll just get blocked by Hellkite. Then I can play Hellkite, copying Hellkite, killing Hellkite, Tamiyo, and my opponent for 1. Or I can just play Hellkite and putting a counter on that and killing that, but there's a Hellkite in play. So I kind of think I attack Tamiyo with Restoration Angel. And if my opponent blocks the Archmage, I'm not too unhappy there. But I assume, yeah, it's going to be a Hellkite block. Then I get to cast this face up. Opponent does know about this card, so should not come as a huge surprise. So I'm going to do 1 to that, and then I guess 4 to that, since that's about it. And then redirect to Tamiyo. Alright, so I'm still fairly ahead, but my opponent has a million mana. I do need to untap so I can play Frost Titan and very nearly win the game. I guess I could have killed Tamiyo and left Archmage, but I still wouldn't have won off Frost Titan, so I think this ends up being better. Certainly wanted to get Tamiyo off the board almost no matter what. Uh-oh, another big spell. Or at least a medium-sized one. Supreme Verdict. Boom. Oh, we've got ourselves a game. Ooh, wow, that was a good one. Unfortunately for my opponent, this Glenlinger Archmage has not been stellar against my all-creature draw here. Get a Hallowed Fountain. Not pay the life. And, yeah, let's go ahead and make some 2/2s. Yeah, so far I've been happier with this than Baneslayer. Certainly didn't want to discard Shapeshifter, and I think Frost Titan's going to be good too. Haymaker after Haymaker. Has my opponent run out? Finally. Looks like let's play this. And let's play a Frost Titan to try to threaten lethal here. Tapping down the Archmage. No real reason not to just go for it. My opponent's got a counter. My opponent's got a counter. And if my opponent had removal, would have killed the Amara Angel before my turn. So yeah. Stay frosty. Whoop. Bam. My opponent did say that it was chilling, but let's see. Well, I don't really like Wall of Omens all that much. Burst Lightning is not incredibly strong. I guess it kills Tamiyo. Definitely like Thalia. Actually, I think I like Silver Knight. Convention Law seems okay. Honor of the Pure doesn't seem all that wonderful. Playing as Wrath is kind of annoying. Brain Freeze could be sweet, but might not be where I want to be. Could also go to Esper Charm and Vindicate. I'd have to splash black, but that might be doable. I do have a Marsh Flats. These cards are pretty good, and I'm siding out bad cards. There's Hokori as well, but against a deck with the Dynamo and Guild Lotus, it makes me a little nervous to play Hokori, and Tamiyo, actually. So I think I actually want to side in these, and I think I want to put in Certainly take out a plains and I guess probably an island for two swamps. Maybe just the one swamp. Could play Rakdos Carnarium. That might not be horrendous. And do I want to set out the plains actually? Yeah, actually, I don't. I mean, Shackles is good, but I think I'll set out an island. Add land, add a swamp. Any other cards bad? I mean, Faithfitters deals with Cameo. Electrolyze is just good value. One of the Pure is not insane, but I think it's good enough. All right.